Alright, we back. The Young Elder, and the name of this tape is Field Trip to Venus. We see that most students have came into the class now, and we're getting ready to drop this galactic class. This is Galactic Family of Life, Part 18, right? We hope all you students got your field trip slip signed, but we're about to go into Venus. Get you some pen and paper out, too, because we hope you got your mathematical skills sharpened, because we get ready to give you another time frame here. You know what I'm saying? You can do your own research on it and find out that what we're telling you is, in fact, the truth. You know what I'm saying? Many devils have ran ahead of us, right, and put these information out as comedy, right, or as fairy tale, because they knew that we wouldn't read. You know what I'm saying? They thought that we wouldn't read and that we wouldn't understand what was going on, right? So we're about to take you over to what Venus looked like and show you what Venus looked like and introduce you to some of the characters who live on Venus. Remember, we told you, you can't go nowhere and not see a Nubian there, right? Yeah, we're about to get into that, right? Because on Venus, the original seed is the Nubian, all right? Now, before we get on my sham and go over to Venus, let me tell you a couple things. Now, in school, they have taught us that Venus is uninhabitable.
Right.
It's too hot. It's too close to the sun that is covered with lava, right? That is uninhabitable. But like we told you before, some people live on the center of their planet. But in Venus' case, Venus is a twin planet to Earth, right? Meaning it looks almost identical to Earth. Everybody get into that, right? So in school, in the textbooks, they show you Venus to keep you in a robotic, mortal state and not give you the understanding on what's going on in your galaxy. They give you Venus covered with melting rock or just as a big gray all brown ball. But this is so far from the truth. So children, file in my sham one by one and take a seat and let's travel. Now, Venus is the second planet from the sun. Venus is 67 million miles from the sun versus Earth being 93 million miles away from the sun. Now Venus, at its closest point, is 24 million miles away from Earth. So we'll be leaving and traveling at this time in order to take you over to Venus, because it's a shorter distance, which on my sham would only take 2 minutes and 13 seconds to make our way over to Venus, okay? So it's only a 2 minute and 13 second trip, but we're gonna add an extra 4 minutes so that we can talk to you and give you a certain amount of things that you need to know before we land and get out and start walking around and introducing you to certain characters. Now, Venus have a breathable atmosphere. Humans can breathe this atmosphere. As we're traveling, the reason why we added the extra 4 minutes is to recalibrate your system to breathe on Venus. Because Venus, they have a high level of carbon dioxide, but with the density and everything being heavier, it doesn't affect, and it creates a more oxidated, with the trees and everything, it creates a more oxidated, yes, there's trees on Venus. About to get into that, okay? So we're recalibrating your system in order for you to breathe on Venus. And this is all it takes, is a little recalibration and you'll be able to breathe their atmosphere because it's breathable, okay? Another thing. At its farthest, it's 167 million miles away. So you can understand it'll take a little longer if we would have went during the time of the year when Venus is at its farthest point away. But we're gonna jump during this time of the year, right? And we're gonna introduce you to some of the things. Now, the story that they told us is that Venus was covered with lava and nobody living on Venus. This is so far from the truth. Now, before we land, we want to get you introduced to some time frames, so we hope you got your pen and paper out so you can get an understanding on the time frame we're dealing with here. Venus is 23,628 miles in circumference, so it's about 1,000 miles less than Earth. So like I told you, it's a twin planet to Earth. Venus looked very similar to Earth, right, with some differences, right? NASA, like we say, NASA show us this picture of this burning ball of rock covered with volcanoes. But that's so far from the truth. Venus was created by the Most High by using his extreme mathematics, right? This is extreme mathematics here, right? Because you gotta understand that nature plays a big part in the evolution of things. Things evolute to survive in different climates, right? So on Venus, it has two thick layers of clouds. One about 1,000 feet up, and then another one, another layer, about another 25,000 feet up. Thick layers to shade the planet. A double envelope of clouds, right? Now, the bad thing about this is the beings, it makes it hard for the beings to view the stars and other planets, but at the same time, it keeps them cool. Venus is mostly a tropical planet, right? Venus is mostly a tropical planet that resembles South Africa and Hawaii, right? Venus have extremely tall trees that reach past the first layer of clouds. These trees keep the surface of Venus cool. These trees can get as tall as 1,000 feet tall, brothers and sisters, right? They have a high-tech level zinc oxidate, right, in the leaves, which acts as sunscreen. These leaves stay green all year round and reflect the sun that makes the planet Venus glow green at night, or go green when you ruin it, right, in some format, right? The thick water-filled clouds, it acts as an AC unit to keep the planet cool, right? It rains two-thirds of the time on Venus in the tropical zone. We're gonna get into what the zones are. They have three different zones. And the tropical zone is the zone that most of the people live in, right? Venus has oceans, ponds, seas, lakes, rivers, waterfalls, the sea. They have a sea, right? The sea in the north, the northern hemisphere, and the sea in the northern hemisphere, they what they call a hot spot, right? It has flow melting rock in the sea, right? It has a river that is almost longer than the Nile, being 4,092 miles long. You know what I'm saying? The natives call this river the River of the Dead, right? Or the Anubis River. Venus has two large continents and several huge, luscious islands, some filled with granite palm trees. We'll be getting into that, these tall palm trees, like I told you. You know what I'm saying? That covers and keep the planet cool. One of the continents is about the size of the United States, and the other is about half the size of the continent of Africa. And they show you on our maps, Africa looks smaller than the United States, but really Africa is really the biggest continent. I think next to Asia, connected with China and all that, but I think Africa really is the biggest continent. But they show us these fossilized maps, they show you that Africa is smaller than the rest of the continent. But so they got a continent on there that's bigger than the United States, and then they got a continent that is to half the size of Africa, which is the continent that looks similar to South Africa when you look at it, right? And the other continent is more like a city-like, like the United States, and we're about to get into that. Venus also has mountains, volcanoes, plains, valleys, hills, caves, and underground tunnels, because these underground tunnels are actually dug by a creature, right? Which I termed the drill turtle, a big old huge thing about the size of an RV. That drills out, yeah, it's an animal, like a worm or some kind of snail or something. We're gonna get into that, right? It has a center world like Earth, which is hollowed out. Venus take 225 Earth days to go around the sun one time. It's really 224 and some change, but we just rounded it off. So Venus take 225 Earth days to go around the sun one time, right? Venus rotates much slower than Earth does. So a day on Venus is much longer than a day on Earth. A day on Venus lasts for 243 Earth days, or 5,832 hours, right? Get that mathematics down, right? One day on Venus is 243 Earth days, right? So they're just one day old, and you almost damn near a year old, right? Venus travels around the sun 1.8 times in this one day. So it's like it's rotating real slow, but it's going fast around the sun. So it have been made it around the sun almost 0.8 times, because like we told you, it takes 225 days to go around the sun, but it takes 243 days to rotate on its axis. A day is considered the time a planet rotates once on its axis. So if one day on Earth, it takes, the planet rotates in 24 hours one day, versus Venus, one day, it takes 243 days to rotate one time on its axis. Therefore, one day is 243 days of Earth time, right, on Venus. Right, write that down. Get into it. Break it down. Study it. Okay? About to get into some time frames here. Okay? The equivalence of a month on Venus is 4,860 Earth days. Okay? 4,860 Earth days. That's one month, which is a 20-day period the natives call an axe. When Venus rotates 21.6 times around the sun, this is one month to the natives on Venus. When Venus go around the sun 280 times around the sun, this is 1 year to the native on Venus. And the native inhabitants divide their days into 27 equal units. It's really 26 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds, but we're gonna break it down for you. These 27 each break down into individual units, which is 9 Earth days long. Then the natives break these individual T's down into a vir, right? Which is considered as a minute, which is 2.66 Earth hours long, right? So 1 minute on Venus is 2.66 hours on Earth. The day begins at the first T, right? At the first hour, right? The natives have 13 months and each having 20 days each. And keep in mind that 1 day on Venus is 243 days, okay? Earth day. So what you do is 243 times 20 times 13, and you'll get to the years. How many days in a year on Venus, right? And it comes out to 173 Earth years for 1 year on Venus. So for 1 year on Venus, it's 173 years on Earth, right? Venus and Uranus is the only two planets that rotate backwards in your solar system, meaning they spin on their axis going backwards compared to the other planet. But they do spin counterclockwise around the sun, but they spin backwards, right? And what we call a retrograde rotation, right? Meaning they spin backwards. Venus have 6.5 months of daylight and 6.5 months of darkness, or shadow hour, right? Venus is divided into 3 zones, right? The Karbol zone, the Strabol zone, and the Trabol zone. The Karbol zone is the Arctic zone, right? Where it maintains negative 175 degrees. So they're telling you about Venus covered with lava when it's a negative at 175 degrees. In the Karbol zone, right? In the Strabol zone, also they have a sea with melted rock in it, right? And in the Karbol zone is negative 175, but in the Strabol zone, it's 462. The degrees is 462 in some spot. So they have hot melted rock inside the sea floating around, right? The Trabol zone is where the equator is located, which is the tropical zone, which maintains 65 to 120 degrees all year round. And this is where most of the natives and the people, the tourists, have set up their campsites, or build their cities, or build their villages. The natives call Venus Amtor, right? It's spelled A-M-T-O-R, right? This is what the natives call their planet. And it's called other names by other worlds. We'll get into that too, okay? The natives, black woolly to straight hair. They have dark brown eyes and they have dark skin. They do not grow facial hair. They are the most diverse group of people on the planet with individual cultures. I mean, they have a lot of different cultures, just like we have a lot of different cultures here as Nubians, right? So the Nubians on Venus have a lot of diverse cultures. They live in both the northern and the southern hemisphere of the planet, right? There's two original Nubian tribes on Venus. The pygmy type, called the pygmy type, and the Watusi type. The Watusi type, they call them Gan, the tribe of Gan, or Dan. What I mean by pygmy type is meaning they only get between 3 and 4.5 foot tall. And the Watusi type, they get in between 6 and 7 foot tall, or 6 and 8 foot tall, with the women being taller than the men, because the women are the most dominant in the Nubian tall tribe on Venus. So the women do all the hunting, the women do all the fighting, the war. They go to war and fight, while the men sit at home and do all the women stuff, like gather sticks for fires, clean the cave, or clean whatever the village, you know what I'm saying, or whatever, right? So it's kind of similar to the lions, when the female lion go out and do the hunting and stuff, and the male lion just sit back and, pretty much relax. Till they kick the kid, then he go in and get his little cut and come on out. So these women are extremely dangerous. They're extremely good at the Manchu art form. They know how to use bow and arrows and swords. And it said that the last couple white people that were sent up there by the secret government that came in contact with this tribe were killed on sight. The men were killed and the women were captured for slaves. As you can guess, these natives, both tribes, the pygmy type and the Watusi type, live all over Venus in all the areas. Some of these Nubians, or these original types, have converted to the Aldebaran ways, and we're about to get into that. Venus have two large continents. One being about the same size as United States, and another being about half the size of Africa, right? The one that's the size of the United States is called Thora or Thora, right, where the being Val Thorn came from, right? His name was Val Thor, meaning he came from the land of Thor. They have several huge islands all over Venus, right? Oceans, ponds, seas, we got into that, right? And some of the water, they have freshwater ponds, freshwater lakes, freshwater seas, and Vepaja, and on Thorae, like say Vepaja is more like South Africa. It looked more like South Africa. So as we're going on to Venus, you'll see that there's a lot of green, the grass and moss and seaweed and these different type of things grow extremely fast and rapidly on Venus due to the 6.5 months of daylight, 6.5 months of night. So they have these bananas. They have bananas that grow wild, nuts, oranges, all the tropical fruits. They grow extremely fast and extremely large. Like an orange might be 3 to 8 times the size of the oranges on Earth due to the sulfuric acid, the carbon dioxide, and different things that they got that's natural fertilizer in their atmosphere. Venus create a natural fertilizer, so you can understand it's like a garden planet. It looks like a garden planet. The banana trees is abundance, right? It's an abundance of bananas trees all the way around, which is eaten by another group that we would call the ape man or monkey man. I'm about to get into them too. A lot of the natives have went underground due to the Aldebarans. Everybody get into them too. The Aldebarans who live on Venus, who call themselves Venerian, right? And like I say, one of them visited Earth. Everybody get into him too. And his people that came with him. If you take a look at this map, you'll see we have three lines. The center line is the equator, right? And in between the Strabol and the Trabol is where most of the people live in, okay? Take a look at that map right there, okay? You see the different islands and the different things. So they've been lying to us, family. Everybody get into it, you know? Venus is divided into two classes, an upper class and a lower class. The lower class is about 500 years ahead of Earth for technology, meaning they have lasers, right? They have different type of weapons, systems, right? They have advanced cities, right? And we're gonna get into those advanced cities. The lower class is about 100 years behind Earth. So they like in the wagon type days. You know what I'm saying? Back in the old Wild Western days type thing, right? And these two fractions culminate giving you a very strange custom. Meaning they have these advanced train systems that go around the planet, right? This vacuum tube type train, which we'll get into, they go around the planet that you can ride, or they ride these big old beasts called Ganters. About to get into those. The natives on Venus are not that enthusiastic about technology, and this is sort of why the two worlds are colliding, right? The natives say that all this technology is poisoning their planet, and they want to uproot the beings who are trying to bring in the technology. Their capital, Rix and Vepaja, often the villages could only be reached by boat or river and canyon. Meaning that you only can get to this boat by going through a river or something. You can't go just walk to this place, right? And the planetary capital, Rex, is located on the most fertile plain in the largest continent, right? The Aldebarans live in these cities, right? These advanced cities, right? We're gonna get to the Aldebarans. The Aldebarans have few children. As space in a social limit, the Aldebarans has passed the Venerian laws, right? Issuing permits to women to only have one, no more than two kids, right? And they can only have another kid if that kid is killed, kidnapped, or replaced in the military or something like that, or killed by a wild beast or something. Also, Aldebarans have half their woman about half as fertile as the Nubians on the planet, which is why they partially jealous. And due to even though they use a longevity serum, they still suffer from menopause, where after a certain amount of time, they can't have kids no more, right? The Aldebarans. The Aldebarans actually issue birth control laws against the Nubians on the planet, just like they do here with the birth control, the Planned Parenthood thing. Same thing they got going on Venus, right? Some of the natives have complied with their evil overlords to disagree with the Aldebarans. Some of them natives could give two shits about the Aldebaran birth rule, right? And they kill Aldebarans on sight, or any white man for that matter. Which remind me of some of the tribes on Earth right now. They kill Caucasians when they see them. That's how they feel about them. They kill these Atabarans when they see them on sight. There is a king over the upper class, which they call a Jun. There's a council over the lower class who wants to take back the throne, because the Atabarans, which the natives call the tourists, they call these beings tourists. And they got a lot of beings who they refer to as tourists, meaning beings who came to the planet after the fact. There are many different types of tourists, right? There are good Atabarans and bad Atabarans. The disagreeable Atabarans overthrew the capital with the help of their reptilian overlords and the bad grays, right? Which is Vepaja, right? For a long time, Vepaja was a dominant nation in the southern hemisphere. You gotta understand, because it's like Egypt. Like, upper Egypt is really like the lower part, and lower Egypt is really at the top part. That's how Venus is, okay? These Atabarans mixed their seed with the natives, creating this new race, which look like the Arabs, right, in Iraq today, right? And they have come up with this life extended serum, which extend their life indefinitely, right? So they appear to look in between 20 and 30. And the Atabarans can live to be over 140 to 1200 Earth years by taking the serum, while the natives can naturally live 480 years of their time, which is well over 100,000 Earth years. Right, the natives can live be over 100,000 Earth years. Right, Vepaja, it looks like South Africa. It looks, and it has similar wildlife. We're gonna get into the wildlife, right? Part of Vepaja is still a third world country, more like parts of South Africa. Right, meaning like I told you, the natives, they still carry bow and arrows, still live off the land. You know what I'm saying? Still refuse to comply to the New World Order on Venus. Right, the same New World Order that's running Earth right now. Right, you have a few cities like if you go to Africa, you go to Nigeria. Nigeria is like a city, right? But then if you go to the bush, it's like nothing's out there with spears still. So it's like this whole, it's the same way, right? As it is above, so it is below, right? Thora look like America, more city-like. They have advanced skyscraper buildings that are built to withstand extreme heat. They appear to be made of some kind of ceramic composite and another element not found on Earth, right? That provides the most heat protection, right? Their cities have tall walls, advanced walls around them, and most people live in apartment-style skyscrapers, right? They have teleportation elevators. They have a vacuum-like shuttle system. This system acts similar to a vacuum system you will find at a bank. The shuttle has a huge clear tube system all around Venus like a subway train. It has a monorail cart system consisting of individual pods that could be hitched together into trains for long distance travel, right? And it slides, right? For long distance travel, and it slides on like a little rail inside of the tube, right? To keep it from spinning around. It levitates on this rail inside of the tube, kind of like a vacuum system though, that you would find at a bank. Like when you go to a bank and you put your money in the little thing and you send it to the little chute to the teller. Well, they have a similar system like that, but a train style system, right? They got something similar to this underground, but this is about at least 50 to 100 years ahead of what they got underground here on Earth, right? Which were given to them by another beings, to more beings who came from another planet, right? So it moves on these rails, it goes under the ocean, it goes around the forest, it goes, you know, all over Venus. And like I said, they drive these huge Gantar beasts around the town to other countries that we're gonna get into. Now, Thora is like a mixed culture, just like America. I mean, it has a lot of different races. I mean, you might have natives on there. You might have natives, Atabarans. You might have the Atabaran native mix. So it's like a mixed culture like America is, right? The dark-skinned original seed called Venus, Amtor. There's a school inside of Venus, right, where the golden temple is. Right, called a temple of love where many souls attend the school and the lectures of love that is given at this golden temple. Some agreeable Atabarans visit Earth on March 16, 1957. One named Captain Valen Thor, right, from the continent of Thorae on Venus. He came with a crew of three other people, Jill Thor, which is his wife, Don Thorne and Dave Thorne, which was his two brothers. They landed in a town called Alexandria, Virginia, and hid their ship over Cook Lake. These extraterrestrial beings would then go on to meet up with Neil Elroy, the Secretary of Defense at the time, and following that, President Eisenhower and Vice President Nixon. Val and Thor is said to have been in connection with the Pentagon for over 65 years, right? Or other beings like Master Farah Muhammad, or Elvis Presley, right? Or Joseph Smith, the leader of the Mormons, all being Venerians. He kind of give you a description of what the outer bands look like, right? The outer bands, which the natives called the Tauris, they came from the outer barrier star system, which is 65 light years away. And 1 light year is 6 trillion miles. So you do 6 trillion times 65, and you get how far outer barracks is away. These outer barracks came as refugees to Venus, right? They have black or dark and brown hair. They have pale skin and can't grow hair on their face since they came to Venus. The ones that born on Venus can't grow hair on their face. They have one big, huge lung instead of having two lungs. They have one big, huge lung, and they have a oversized heart, which is a little bit to the right instead of like humans' heart being a little bit to the left. Their heart is a little bit larger and to the right, to the upper center of their chest. They have gray, blue, and green eyes, and they can get to 6 or 7 foot tall, right? They have a clone race, which they mix with the tall whites and created what they call the giant outer barons, which can get up to 10 feet tall, right? And some of them got blonde hair, the leaders. The leaders got blonde hair. A disagreeable outer barons came and agreeable outer barons came to Venus, right? The disagreeable outer barons control Venus. All right, let's get into some of the other animals on the planet of Venus, okay? I want to talk to you about the Tarban. The Tarban is a feline cat, right? A predator that is larger than the lion, which is usually found in the native forests of Africa, right? This Tarban, also known as the peppermint tiger, is a ferocious species of Venerian carnivores, right? Red hair with white stripes, like a peppermint, with a black horse mane going down the back of its spine. It has powerful jaws and 3 feet, and armed with sharp claws. It can weigh as much as 600 pounds, and they can hear and see extremely well, right? They can go nocturnal, right? Because remember we told you, Venus can go into a 6.5 month nighttime, so these cats can go nocturnal, and they can hunt at night and see at night real good, right? These triban obviously evolved parallel with the great cats on Earth in order to fulfill, right, an equivalent ecology plan. That is what is known as the parallel evolution, which takes place upon many worlds, right? And these tribans, they prey on the lunar bargans and the bistos. These tigers, or these peppermint tigers, have been seen hunting alone and also hunting in groups of packs, right? The lunar bargans, or the no bargans, the ape mans, or an ape-like hairy man on Venus, which with extremely close-set eyes and a baboon-like face. They walk upright and on 2 legs and have rough hair covering their eyes and body. They smell horrible and suffocating. They're flat-footed and their hands have heavy point claws like nails on them, right? And they're the most primitive race on Venus. They have need for only about 100 words and live in poor constructed huts and eat the flesh of the local human population with little care. The men and women have few differences and are equal in their culture. They do not appoint a king in their tribe, and their weapons are primitive, such as the bow and a sling. The Bistos is a large creature native to Venus. It is taller than a man at the shoulders and can weigh up to 3,600 tobs, right, which is 1,200 pounds. A tob is 1/3 of a pound on Venus, right? A tob is 1/3 of a pound. These creatures somewhat resemble a crossbreed between the American bison and a large boar. It has powerful jaws and 4 great fangs in addition to its other teeth, and 2 heavy horns atop his head, and a boar-like snout, right? Like wild hogs, wild pigs, right? These are huge wild pigs, right? This creature is actively hunted by the natives for food, right? And extremely dangerous to hunt. They usually move in herds, and if you kill one, you will have to kill them all. They go by the code "No Man Left Behind." They don't usually eat humans, but will make an exception for you if you go jacking around with them, right? They are not poisonous to eat for Earth people, so if you on Venus,
and can't kill one, they make a great, awesome steak if you're not vegetarian, right, like us. You have the Brocodes. You have the Brocodes people, right, which are humanoid plant race that live in the northern hemisphere, right, which the natives also call tourists. They came from the Vega star system a million years before the Outer Barrens. Like I say, the natives call these beings tourists from the Vega star system, which is 25 light years away. They are humanoid plant people, right? They have green skin and absolutely no hair on the top of their head. There is a knob that remains from their birth, somewhat similar to a belly button. The females of this species give birth to a single nut, which a tree grows from. Tiny Brocodes grow like fruit upon the trees. The vast majority of these young plants are eaten by the guy piles, right? The guy piles, which is a bird, we're gonna get into them, right? These plant beings, which are the real Spider-Man, right? They drink the warm blood of creatures, including humans. They are the real Spider-Man, you know what I'm saying? They can shoot a web-like vine from the top of their head and swing from limb to limb, right? And like I said, their worst enemy is the guy piles.
So as you walk around on Venus and you're in a hurry because a time band on your ass, right? Or a group of them, right? Or some other strange creature, right? Don't forget to keep your eyes to the sky. It's a creature called the guy pile. And the guy pile is a huge-ass bird that kind of resembles the pterodactyl, right? The big birds that supposedly be extinct, which have some of them moved to the center of the earth, right? So they resemble this pterodactyl, right? And they huge. They have ova, right? These guy piles, right? They actively prey on the young Brocodes. Right, the human plant people. They also eat small humans and other small creatures, right? And the baby of the fish people, right? The baby of the fish people, about to get into the fish people too. They also eat human infants. The guy pile live in the top of the mountains on Venus. Some of the mountains can get higher than the mountains on Earth, right? They have 30 feet wingspan and hatch from 7 foot tall eggs. The guy pile can get as big as a C-31 aircraft. They can fly high up at sea a long way. They can glide for over 50 miles without flapping their wings. They have sharp, powerful claws and beaks. They resemble the bird, like I said. They resemble the pterodactyl, right? So when walking on Venus and looking around and watching your ass, make sure you look up and watch your goddamn ass too, because these motherfuckers will swoop down on you, swoop you up, take you right up in the mountain, and chew you up and feed you to the babies. You see what I'm saying? The fish people of Venus, they live in the northern hemisphere, right? They inhabit a city called Mypost, right? And they call the Mypost people, right? They came from Cyrus' star system millions of years ago. They are also referred to as tourists by the native people there. The Mypost people, they start their life off as fish. The females of the species spun in a private pool, spawning thousands of potential millions of the young. The Mypost people, right, make their way to the oceans through underground tunnels, though most of the young die before they can return to their family pool. The infants always return to the pool they were spawned in, which ensures inbreeding, right? Because these Mypost people don't like to mate with the outside of their family, right? As a young Mypost grows, they develop legs and arms and venture onto land. Until this time, they are highly vulnerable to the guy piles again, the big ass birds I just told you about, right? They can get as tall as 7 foot once they get grown and grow the legs and all that. This fish-like, they have a fish-like large face, right? They have web-like hands and feet, and they are capable of breathing water and breathing on land. Having few facial expressions, they typically use their gills to show emotion, right? They can push air out between their teeth to create a whistle indicating anger and form a O with their lips and suck in air to display laughter. Yeah, man, this is real shit, man, right? I will go into the bird people, right? The bird people, which the native people also call the tourists, the bird race consists of an inferior race that exists as slaves. These bird races slaves to the tourists of the Outer Barrens, right? They are said to have little intelligence and have no imagination, and their motive only be primitive emotions such as hunger, love, fear, self-preservation, and hate. They serve whoever their master is.
They have dark skin, low retreating foreheads, large beak-like noses, right? An undershot jaw, and small close-set eyes. The ears of this race are flat and pointed. Their chests are large and bird-like. The lower part of their torso is small, and they have narrow hips, right? Their arms are long with long fingers and heavy legs, and the legs are short and stocky, ending in three toes with curved claws. On their heads, there's feathers instead of hair, right? And they are uniform in color. And like I say, these beings are just servants of the Atabarans, like they pets, the bird beings. They got the dogs and birds as they pets. They can get up to 7 foot tall, and they can weigh as much as 250 pounds, all muscle, man. Then you have what I call the Venus flytrap humanoid people, right? Who kind of resemble the Aztec Indians down in South America. Except they have a red line going down the middle, right? The natives call these people tourists too because they are a crossbreed between the plants and humans, okay? This race appear to look human, but they have certain sight differences. Like I say, each member of the race have a red line going down the center of their body, dividing them in two halves, slightly symmetric to each other. Because one half is a woman, female, and one half is male. And they reproduce by splitting themselves in half. One half grows, and the other half grows and become another person with a split down the middle again. They eat, different things, just like the, they eat humans. They eat, some of the different animals. They don't eat the big animals. They eat, like, stuff that they can open up and swallow in the middle of their body like a Venus flytrap. They seduce humans, get them into their little area, and then eat them. So some of the people they set up there got ate by these people, and that's how they found out about them. Right? So these people are what I call the Venus flytrap people. And sometimes one of the halves will fail to develop properly and will be incapable of reproducing. We're reading some of this from my book that's about to get ready to drop, Field Trip to Venus. This will go into more detail on this thing. They have the race of house cat-sized rats, kind of similar to the neutral rat. They weigh up to 40 pounds, right? They call them misters, right? They feed on just about anything, and according to the locals, they came, when the Atabarans came, they came off their ships. To call somebody a mister on Venus is an insult. It's a symbol to calling them a rat or a pig or something. They also have these big, huge ganses that's about 1.5 size of the elephants. They domesticated them on Venus, right? It has a bull head, has a snout 4 to 5 foot long horn growing from its head. It has a large mouth and powerful jaws filled with teeth. So these gantars are these huge beasts that they ride around, like the Persians used to ride the elephants back in the day, right? They have a blue fish-like people who walk upright, who live under the oceans, right? These people have human-shaped bodies, but with distinct features, the fins up on their head and the webbed feet and hands. They wear no clothes and don't seem to have any distinctive sexual features other than shape. Their bodies are incredibly frail. They are especially bags of water, and they can easily be punctured or killed. Their transparent skin reveals some of their inner organs, right? And these are what these people look like. Then they have the Targo, which is the huge spider, right? Which these spiders are native to Venus. They are the predators. They have multiple yellow eyes. They got hair all over them and poisonous veins, and long claws capable of grabbing a man. Extremely strong webs, stronger than rope, called a tauri, right? These creatures are greatly important to the natives on Venus, having many use, not least of which is what they make their clothes from. So they make the clothes from the hides of these beings, of these big old spiders, right? Like I say, Venus have many different types of fish in their sea, similar to the fish on Earth. They have these different types of birds similar to chickens, right? And they run around, they're a little bit bigger than chickens, about 3 or 4 times bigger than a chicken, and the natives eat these, right? There's also bears who grow extremely long necks, I guess due to these bears eat vegetarians. These bears with the long neck eat veggies, so I guess due to the tall trees, they grew
adapted and grew long necks. They have this huge alligator looking fish. They can get over 1,000 feet long, right? And these things are real aggressive. They are one of the many leviathans or reptilian style hunters that live under the ocean and seas on Venus. Okay, you come in contact with these beings if you're trying to sail on a little boat. I don't think that's a good idea, because these beings will eat you and your boat, right? So we just want to get you, open your mind up to what's going on here, right, on Venus. Like I said, the natives speak a tongue that sound like the same language as Arabic, an old form of Arabic with no vowels, right? And the national language is the Venerian language, which sounds similar to English without the vowels. So we're just trying to get this information over to you so you can have an understanding on what's going down on Venus. Now next week we're gonna be dropping the class field trip tomorrow, right? So we hope this class opened up your mind to what's going on in the galaxy. And like we say, you might wanna watch it 2 or 3 times, get an understanding on the time frames, the screen mathematics. This is your young elder. Make sure you subscribe to the channel because we drop videos every week or every couple days. New information is coming out as we move forward, right? Galactic 19 next week, field trip to Mars. This is your young elder. We love you all. Signing out. Good night.